Wise Vision is Smith College's digital signage solution. Creating content for digital signage is a three-step process. First, you design the look and messaging of your content within a presentation. Second, the presentation is added to a schedule to determine when it's shown. Third, that schedule is then assigned to a display to determine where it's shown. Before getting started, it's important to know that Wise Vision is optimized specifically for use in Google Chrome. You will encounter errors if you try using it in Firefox, Safari, or other browsers. To begin creating content for your digital signage, go to risevision.com and sign in using your Smith College Google account. You should have been previously added to the Wise Vision system by an administrator. Your initial homepage will display a list of all presentations, schedules, and displays used by your department, which is referred to as a subcompany in Wise Vision, Smith College being the main company. To begin, click on Add Presentation. You'll be shown a list of templates that you can use, some free and others at a cost, but for now, just choose blank. Before adding content, click on the Presentation Properties gear icon found at the top. Just like any other files being accessed in a shared environment, it's important to give your presentation a name that is clear and descriptive. I name my presentations with a prefix based on where it will be shown. For example, most of my presentations are created for the Center for Media Production, so I start the name with CMP. That way, someone else looking at the list of presentations will know this presentation was created for the CMP. Make sure your presentation matches the resolution of your display. Most displays will be 1920 by 1080 wide. Next, use the color picker to choose a background color for this presentation. Or click on the Use Image checkbox to upload your own background image. The process for uploading your own image is simple. Click on the storage icon to the right. Before uploading files, it's a good idea to think about how your department's files will be used and consider making appropriate folders for organization. For instance, I'm part of Educational Technology Services, or ETS, but we have multiple areas with digital signage, such as the Learning Commons and Sealy Basement, and the Center for Media Production. Most content for these areas will be different, and so rather than having our main storage area cluttered with many unrelated files, we've made separate folders. When you're ready, click Upload Files and select your background image. Once your file is uploaded, then click Apply. Your presentation will then update to the background image you've selected. Every piece of content in a presentation, images, video, text, etc., are displayed in placeholders, or boxes of content. Click on the green Add Placeholder button. You will see a blank placeholder appear on your presentation. The surrounding frame will not appear in your published presentation. In the left-hand column, we can choose to add images, video, text, or more items such as spreadsheets, calendars, or web pages. Choosing text will bring up the text editor, which works just like any word processing program. If your text doesn't fit, you can always adjust the size and location of your placeholder before or after entering your text. If you wish to go back and edit the text, simply click on the Text Widget link on the left. If you click away from the placeholder you just created, you'll see on the left a list of all placeholders. By default, the placeholders are given the name of PH and the number. This doesn't provide useful information about the placeholder, so it's a good habit to rename each one. To do so, click on the placeholder and then click on the Properties tab. Next to Name, click Edit, rename the placeholder, and then click Apply. From the Properties tab, we can also fine-tune the placeholder's size and location, as well as change the placeholder's individual background if we wish. When done editing, press Back. Placeholders can act as a playlist or a slideshow, rotating through multiple pieces of content. Add a new placeholder and upload several images. For this example, I want to show off the equipment we have for loan in the CMP, so I've made this CMP equipment folder for these images. I'll start by selecting my first image. Make sure that Scale to Fit is checked so that if the placeholder is resized, the images will scale with it. Click Save. With that placeholder selected, I can choose Image again, pick a second image, and then click Save. Now we see two images listed under the Playlist tab. I'll add a third in the same way. Next to each image in the playlist is a duration which can be adjusted. I'll change each image's duration to 3 seconds. Click on the Properties tab and name the placeholder, then click Apply. To review the playlist I just set up, click on Save and Preview in the top right. This will load a preview of that presentation in a new window or tab. All three images are displayed for 3 seconds each, just as I had set it up. You now have the basic tools to create dynamic presentations in RiseVision. When your presentation is ready, click Save and then Publish. Afterwards, click on Schedules. A schedule is simply a programmed slideshow made of presentations. To create a new schedule, click Add Schedule, and then name your schedule. You can have this schedule shown always, or if you uncheck the Always box, you can adjust exactly when you want that schedule to be shown on a particular display, right down to the hour. You can set a start and end date, or change when it recurs. Finally, select which display or displays you want this schedule to appear on and click Apply. Then, click on Add Playlist Item and choose either Presentation or URL, which lets you display any web-hosted content, such as a website. From Presentation, choose the presentation you just created. If this schedule will only show one presentation, that presentation will be shown looped over and over. However, if you have multiple presentations, you must enter in a specific duration for each presentation. Then click Add, then click Save. After a couple of minutes, your display should now be showing the schedule you just created. If you click on the Display tab, you can view all available displays and any relevant information about them. The Storage tab lets you organize any uploaded media. However, if you choose to move something in storage that is already in use, you will receive a warning instructing you that you will need to go back to that presentation and manually update that piece of content.